I take it yours is busted again?
Mine too. Top government agency, and we have one working stapler between us.
Make that no saber because this one is busted too.
Maybe it's just empty.
Maybe it's just jammed.
Whoa, no. What are you doing? You're gonna break it.
And here are the hardest working special agents in law enforcement.
Welcome back, Ducky.
Eleanor, allow me to introduce Casey Hines, my graduate assistant. Casey, this is...
Wait, don't tell me. Eleanor would make you Agent Bishop, and you look more like an Agent McGee than a Torres, which would make you Agent Torres.
Damn it, I don't look like a McGee.
Well, kind of look like a McGee with a tan, maybe.
Casey insisted on accompanying me.
Like I had a choice. Publisher's expecting his first 5 chapters on Monday, and we're nowhere close.
Oh, we're not that far. I hired Casey to keep me on schedule. Little did I know she would be so emphatic.
And I'll be emphatically furious if you miss your deadline. We still have a ton of notes to transcribe. Plus, his chapter on unsolved cases will need a big rewrite if this Flintstones thing pays off.
Flintstones?
Yeah, Gibbs called me about it last night, and I must say, this thing looks very Flintstones.
What the hell is that thing?
It's a ceremonial Viking war stick. It was adopted by an obscure fraternal organization back in the 1800s.
Gibbs and Ducky think it's also the missing weapon to an unsolved case.
16 years ago, I pulled a single wooden spike from the skull of a young petty officer.
You never trace it to a weapon?
No, not until just now.
And you have got to be Jethro! Hi!
Casey's work on my book has made her very familiar with the team. Perhaps a little too familiar.
It's an honor, really. I mean, Doc is writing some great stuff about you.
Okay. Yeah, okay. McGee.
Yeah, boss. Well, as you saw on the show last night, the woman chose not to sell the item in question.
$3,000.